Hello student, welcome back. And today we are going to continue some of the question. Question is very important. So, this is chapter 6. A microwave oven 1.2 kilowatt. Okay, just now the aircon is 1.5 kilowatt, so the aircon use slightly more. Not I did calculate lah, but at least we can estimate lah, agak-agak. A microwave use 1.2 kilowatt and is using 240 watt. Calculate the current. Still remember the formula or not? Okay, so I give you time to try. The formula is up there at page. Somewhere around here. Yeah, the formula is at here. So I see you can, the formula is at here. Yeah, see you can find the answer or not. Okay, so let's try do this question. So power, still remember the formula or not? Power equals to voltage times ampere. Power is W, voltage is V, ampere is A. So I just write the formula. Sometimes the formula also got marked. So 1.2 kilowatt. I straight away change lah, huh? Because it's kilowatt. So I straight away times 1000. No, huh? Remember, kilowatt you need to times 1000. So I get 1200 watt. Equals to voltage times ampere is voltage 240, ampere is A, so the ampere is equivalent to 1200 divided by 240, so you get 1200 divided by 240, you get 5 ampere. Very good. So congratulations to those that got the answer. So wait, just write here 5 ampere. Very good. Let me erase this one because I got no place to write. Every time I need to erase type. Okay, question number four. An electric rice cooker is 800 watt and 230 watt switch on in 30 minutes. How much electrical energy is used in the rice cooker? I will just teach, but if you want, you can anytime you can pause the video and try to learn by yourself. Okay, so you might want to try this one. Okay, so for number four, let's try to do. I just need to get some empty space so I can write. Okay, so I got empty space. How much electrical energy used by the rice cooker? He got give me the voltage, and he got give me the time. I need to find the electrical energy. Okay, so how to find electrical energy? Okay, so I will use this formula because I got electrical energy, joule, I got time, I got power. So power equals to energy divided by time. So I use the formula. Jump in bigger bit, not enough space. Okay, so I got what is the formula again? Power equals to energy divided by time. Power is W, if you still remember, energy is J, and time is S. So I draw here, we got not enough space. So we got 800 watt. 800 equals to, I do shortcut a bit lah, energy, I just put J lah. J equals to time, I need to change to second. So 30 minute times 60. So J equals to, formula lah, 800 times 30, go up ah. I don't need to do ah. I mean, you know ah, mathematics ah. I don't need to show the linear, okay? 800 times 30 times 60, you get 1,144,000 joule. Yeah, so this is the answer. 144 the energy equals to 1,440,000, or I change it to kilojoule. Okay, kilojoule is 1,440 kilojoule. I mean, from gram to kilogram, something like that. Okay, so it's easier to see. Okay, yeah. Okay, so for question number 2, calculate the cost energy is used by the cost is 30 cents. Okay, so let's see, let's try to do this question. I got the power, the voltage, the ampere, and the time. Okay, this is the thing that I already got. I got the time, and I even got the ampere already. Calculate the cost per unit is, calculate the cost per kilowatt is 30 cents. So the per unit is 30 cents. Let's refer to the formula at page 198. And down here, the formula. Okay, first I need to calculate how many unit. Electrical use equals to power times time. Okay, so I just copy it back. Yeah, but always when I go down, I cannot remember already leh. Short term memory loss. I just write here unit lah, kWh. The unit kWh equals to kWh, the unit lah, times the time per 1 hour times time in terms of 1 hour. So this is the thing that's doing confused, because sometimes they give hour, then they give second, and give hour, they give second, then student confused. Okay, so kilowatt will be 0.8. I do shortcut a bit lah. Because sometimes students will write here 800, then you will get it wrong, because the unit is kW, so you need to change to kW, means 800 I need to divide 1000, so I get 0.8. But in the exam, you just do the formula lah. In the exam, you just write 800 over 1000, so that in case the working got marks, times the time, this also you, 30 minute, I don't want to do the formula, huh? The answer is 0.5, because 1 hour got 60 minute and 30 minute got half an hour. Okay, so no need to take this one, because I do shortcut a bit easy. Actually, I'm very lazy, but something like that, I hope you understand. Don't know, please don't be shy, put a comment below, and I will help you, or other student will help you. Okay, so 0.8 times 0.5, I get 0.4. So basically I get 0.4 unit. Okay, 0.4 unit. Now I already got a unit. Follow back the example only in case you don't know. 0.4 unit. Where is it? So I already got the unit. Cost equals to unit times the price. Okay, so let's put here. So the cost equals to unit times the price. So I will get unit 0.4 times the price, which is 30 cents. So I do 0.4 times 30 cents. So I get the cost is RM 0.12 cent. 0.12 cent, RM 0.12. So little, did I calculate wrong? Yeah, actually for question 4A, I think I did wrong already. How much electrical energy used by the rice cooker? So because just now I checked, there's a electrical energy used in term of kWh, and here also we have electrical energy used in terms of J-Joule. So we have two electrical energy use, but because the question give power and time, so I think because the question give power and time, so should be use this formula kWh is the power times time. Okay, so sorry for number 4A, so is kWh equals to power times time equals to means power is kW equals times time is per hour. So for 4A, 0.8 kilowatt times the time is 30 minute change to hour 0.5 hour. So you get 0.8 times 0.5, you get 0.4 kWh. Okay, so there's a that's the answer lah, 0.4 kWh. That's why the question actually should be improved. Like, you want the answer in kWh or you want it to be in joule? This is sometimes it will confuse the student, but I think exam won't. Because exam usually they will give you the unit, find the answer in this unit. So thank you to one of my student that point out this error. Okay, so yeah, for 4A and 4B. 5A, what is the importance of star rating labeling of electrical appliances? Why the star rating is important? So we already learned the star rating is important because, yeah, here's the star. He didn't say. But of course, 5-star is the best, okay? It show the energy rating. So maybe you can say something like 5-star is important because it will help the student, help the student blah, help the consumer to know the efficiency of the electrical product appliances. Or maybe you can add more lah, and consumer can save energy, he know what things to buy, he can evaluate the item. Many things lah, because this is no right and no wrong answer. It's a K-BUT question. How many star in the star rating label in the appliances should be used? Explain. So how many star you want to use? Of course you want to use 5-star. Why? Maybe we can say it has high level of energy efficient use. It can save electric. The energy consumption is lesser. It can save money. Something like that lah. So basically the efficiency lah we want to talk about. The 5-star means more efficient in terms of energy use. 1-star means less efficient in terms of energy use. Okay. Okay, so let's learn about a bit conclusion of what this whole chapter that we learn. I believe that this has been a difficult journey to learn all these electrical thing because electrical is a chapter that quite complicated and many things we need to cover. Okay, so we know we already learned energy, renewable energy and non-renewable energy, and by using the energy we can make kinetic energy to produce current, induce current, produce electric current. So when the magnetic field line, still remember or not how to produce electric? As long as you use a, something to cut the magnetic field, the metal, it will produce certain induced current into here. But the problem is it, when you cut, it will go here. When you go up, it will go back. So it will go up, go back, which is something that you don't want. Then we have the thing. Then we have this thing called the what? Carbon DC generator, or we call it the commuter carbon brush, so that the electric will keep on flowing because the magnet also the this thing will turn. Very difficult to explain that, but as you turn, it actually produce the current in a one direction. So now we know how to get the electric, and after that in electric we have alternating current like this, and we have direct current. So in alternating current, we can use transformer to transform, increase the voltage or decrease the voltage. Up to you lah, huh? You want to increase the voltage or decrease it. But why we want to increase voltage, remember or not? We increase the voltage so that there will be less resistance as it travel from the network grid. And then when the network grid want to reach your house, they step down the transformer again, so that you can use in your house. This is the direct current. Yeah, but the problem with direct current is you cannot use transformer. This one you need to know, because direct current, no transformer, and alternating current is transformer. Most appliances, I think high voltage one is usually alternating current. Then we have transmission, we know already, MCB, network grid, this one the exam ask, I think no problem, because this one is just memorized. Electrical efficiency, still remember, calculate the percentage. I think you forget, maybe you want to know, maybe you remember like how many percent of useful energy, maybe 30%, 40%. Let's say your energy you produce 60, but you give output is 100, so 60 divided by 100 times 100, so the efficiency is 60%, and all the formula stuff, okay? Not easy, yeah, this chapter, really not easy, okay? Power station that use wind energy do not contaminate the air, so this is true. Solar cell can produce electrical current, so this is false. Two pin plug are not connected to the earth wire, true. Okay, so coal is non-renewable, biomass, geothermal, and wave is renewable. Number four, a coil of wire is moved in the direction of the arrow through the space between two magnets as shown in figure one. Okay, what is the effect of the magnetic field when the coil is moved? Okay, very good. So it's magnetic field line are cut. Magnetic field line are cut. So you can produce induced current. What produced in the coil of the wire? Okay, induced current. Very good. Induced current. What happened to the LED? Explain your answer. Okay, so the LED will light up. Very good. Light up because got electric mah, of course it will light up. And name a device, for example we have generator, okay, the turbine, the generator. Figure 2.8 show a device used to investigate electrical current. Okay, name the device shown. Yes, CRO, but in the exam you just write the full word lah, cathode ray oscilloscope. What are the properties of electrical current studied using this device? Correct, okay, shape of graph, direction of the current, and voltage of the current. Figure 2B and 2C show two traces displayed on the screen. Okay, one is like that, one is like that. Depending on what you turn on and turn off, Name the type of electric represent by 2B and 2C. Okay, so 2B is AC and this one is DC, direct current. Okay, so I think this one you can read by yourself and try to do by yourself. And this one also you can read by yourself and do by yourself. Right? I think the question that we should focus more is, well, still got a lot to go. So, okay, so I will teach until here. So maybe next video, either I see lah, whether I want to cover chapter 7 or I want to continue from this question. So that's it for this video, and I see you next time. Bye bye.